Lord. Hallelujah. He is worthy. He is worthy, church. Yes, he's worthy. Yes, he's worthy. Yes, he's worthy. He's worthy. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. He's worthy.
Yes, Father.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Lord. I don't care how it hurt this morning. You're going to be all right. God is good. Worthy to be praised. He will never leave you nor forsake you.
Amen.
Oh, yes, Father. Thank you, God. God is moving in the house.
Yes, Father.
Lord, thank you, Jesus. Before I get into the prayer, I just want to thank God for all things.
Yes.
You know, the enemy is working. I'm going to tell you how strong the enemy can be.
Yes.
I was going to a yard sale yesterday, and the guy across the street, I know it's him. He went out there and took out all my sons.
Oh.
But it's all right, because you know what? From the time I got up, me and my daughter and granddaughter, and put it out, we made our goal.
That's right.
You can take down whatever you want to take. At the minute you took it down, we was ready to take it in.
Yeah.
He figured he'd stop the flow of traffic.
Yes.
So he don't have to see people's coming in. I mean, it was a flow of traffic. But we didn't block his driveway.
Amen.
Everybody was polite. So what is your problem?
Yeah.
I even went over to this man, introduced myself. I said, my name is Olivia Seale. Sorry I didn't get to introduce myself sooner. He looked at me, I stuck my hand out, he looked at me, touched me and walked away.
Mm.
I don't know if his name is Adam, Joseph, or whatever, because he didn't say a word.
Mm.
But you know what, God is good.
Yes.
You can do whatever you want to for his children.
Yes.
We will overcome.
Yes. Amen.
So I said, you know what? It's all good. I'm going to pray for him.
Yes.
One way I'm going to pray for him that I don't kick his butt.
Amen.
Because it takes a lot for me not to do what I want to do to him. Because he is an evil man. My granddaughter spoke to him. He walked away. How can you deny a child? Hello. A child. Hello. Bye. And you walk away. I told my grandchild, she don't understand. That's ignorance with no name. But it's all good. You cannot hurt me. Ain't nothing you can do to me. You can do anything you want, but I'm going to come out on top, because I'm God's child.
Yes.
So you can do whatever you want to do.
Amen.
And I told my daughter, we are God's chosen people.
Yes.
Do whatever you want. We've never done anything to you except try to be nice.
Yes.
But there's a devil on every street.
Yes.
Amen.
And when he get up, he punches the clock.
Amen.
He got up. People don't realize the devil was in heaven.
Yes, right.
He wanted to take over.
Yes.
He wanted control. He wanted to be above Jesus.
Yeah,
and he had to leave.
Yes.
You know, get out.
Yes.
We're kicking you back where you come from.
Yes.
You cannot control the house of God.
Yes, God.
Only God controls the house of God, not you.
Yes, Lord.
So you got to go, devil.
Yes.
So I said today, devil got to go.
Yes.
I said, Lord, in Jesus' name,
yes,
we're going to come into the house of Job.
Yes.
And he said, come on in the room.
Yes,
and I tell my kids every day, come on into the room.
Yes, God.
He's your doctor.
Yes, Lord.
He writes all your prescriptions
yes, God.
In that room.
Yes,
I don't care what kind of prescription room.
Yes, yes.
I'm sorry,
yes,
but this
Lord.
Is the way it is.
Yes, Lord.
I said, this is it.
Yes, Lord.
You come on into the room of House of Joy. Because when I walked up and got out of that car, I heard y'all all the way out on the street. If you cannot hear these people praying to the Lord and invite him into this house, you got a problem.
Yes.
You should be out there knocking on the door trying to believe.
Yes, yes.
Because God is in the house of God. And he's doing his work.
Yes.
You cannot stop him.
Yes.
I wouldn't even try.
Yes.
I come to tell you something. Get up to come to church, hurting and aching, it is a problem. But when you look toward the house, which covers your heaven, you ain't got a problem throwing on some clothes and coming.
Yes.
Long as you clean, smell good, get out of there.
Amen.
Come on out here and enjoy the house of God. Talk to the Lord. Tell him what you want. He said, you have not because you asked not.
Amen.
Come on, ask God what you want.
Amen.
I tell him every day, strength, healing, prayer, finances, take care of my children.
Amen.
Take care of the house of Job.
Yes. Amen.
Take care of Pastor Scott.
Yes.
Because I could not walk out on these streets and talk to people.
Yes.
My heart don't let me.
Yes.
My nerves are shot.
Yes. Amen.
People just killing people every day.
Yes.
But
Amen.
God got it.
Yes, Lord.
God got it. We got to have no fear. And fear is something hard to conquer.
Yes.
You cannot conquer fear. Because
yes.
A man walk up to you with a gun, fear comes all over you.
Amen.
All over you.
All over, yes.
There's nothing you can do except flee.
Yes.
Run.
Yes.
Say, Pete, don't fail me now.
Yes. Amen.
And get going.
Yes. Call me Jesus.
Call Jesus. Yes.
Amen.
Call him.
Amen.
Jesus, if you give me one step, I promise you I'll make two.
Amen.
Help me, Lord.
Hallelujah.
Because this week has been a week.
Yes.
And I said, Lord, take me. Lord, in Jesus' name. Lord, I come into the house of Job.
Yes,
I said, take care of us.
Yes.
Bless us.
Yes.
Put a shield around us. Keep us healthy. Keep us strong.
Yes.
When we walk out this door, let people know we are your child.
Yes.
Amen. I ask you to take care of us, Jesus. Take care of all the pastors. All the mothers of the church, all the members, take care of these children that sat under our voice, that they would come up right. Lord, I ask you in Jesus' name, please, you say you have not, because Lord God, you ask not. And I'm asking today in Jesus' name, take care of Jesus. In Jesus' name, amen.
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 Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Yes, God.
I'm going to ask Reverend Jason to come raise a prayer for us too.
Yes.
Come on now.
Yes. Yes.
Hallelujah.
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 Yes, God. Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord.
Thank you,
Lord.
Hallelujah.
Yes, God. Thank you, Jesus.
Lord.
Thank you, Jesus. Yes, God. Thank you, Lord.
Thank
you, Jesus.
God, we thank you.
Yes, Father. Yes, God.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Yes,
God.
Hallelujah.
Yes,
hallelujah.
Yes, God.
When we think of the goodness of Jesus.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Yes.
Hallelujah. We can cry out.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank you,
Lord. Thank you, Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Yes, Lord.
God, have had to win this place today, God.
Yes, God.
In the name of Jesus.
Yes, God. Thank you.
Lord, you know what your people need, God.
Yes, God.
In the name of Jesus.
Yes, God. Thank you.
Lord, you know him name by name,
yes,
God. Hallelujah, Jesus.
Yes,
God, meet the needs today, God.
Yeah.
In the name of Jesus,
yes.
God. Lord, we know, God,
yes,
that you're able to do all things yourself,
yes.
God. Hallelujah,
yes, God.
Lord, when we're going through our trials,
yes,
God. Lord, we ask you, God, that we look not to the flesh, God. But God, that we look to the hills, God. For where comes our help, God? Because we know, God, our help comes from you, Lord. Hallelujah, God. We know, God, that you can do what no man can do, God. Hallelujah, God. And God, we want to thank you. We just want to thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. 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 Lord, we praise you, God. Hallelujah. Glory, glory, glory. Hallelujah. Glory to God.
Glory.
Yes, Lord.
Amen. You praise God for your death. Hallelujah.
Yes, Lord.
He can fill them in the inside. Yes. Hallelujah. Yes. Hallelujah. Yes. Thank you, Jesus. Yes. Somebody say, what is this thing? Hallelujah. Yes. That make people act the way they act.
Yes.
Hallelujah. Make people shout the way they shout.
Yes.
Hallelujah. Have people talking in different tongues.
Yes.
Hallelujah. Having joy and going through the trial.
Yes.
What is this thing?
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Yes.
We thank God for Jesus today.
Yes.
Hallelujah. Glory to God. Lord, yes, you got to look on the past of God.
Yes, Lord.
In the name of Jesus, God, glory, yes, you got you touching God.
Yes, Jesus.
Touch upon the crown of his head, God, even to the soles of his feet, God.
Yes,
in the name of Jesus, God. Lord, meet his knees, God. In the name of Jesus, God. Nobody know the trials that he had with himself, God. Hallelujah, God. Nobody see the tears, God. But you, oh God. Hallelujah, God. God, we ask you, God, just to work it out right now, God. In the name of Jesus, God. Hallelujah, God. God, we thank you. Lord, we thank you, God, that the race is not given to the swift.
Yes,
hallelujah, nor to the strong. Hallelujah, but he that endures to the end. Hallelujah. Lord, we thank you, God, for endurance today, God. Hallelujah, Jesus.
Yes,
Lord, we could have gave up, but we didn't give up, God.
Yes,
hallelujah, God. We thank you for you are the keeper, God.
Yes, Father.
Hallelujah,
thank
God.
You,
we thank you, Lord. Bless everyone here, God.
Yes, Father.
In the name of Jesus.
Thank you, Lord
God.
Jesus.
We ask you, God, that you continue to bless, God.
Yes, God. Bless
we ask you, Lord, that people will feel loose in their spirit, God.
Yes, God.
Amen, God.
Yes,
God. Amen, God. That they Lord. May be able to worship
yes,
you, God.
God.
So we know, God, that when the praise go up,
yes.
Hallelujah, the blessings come down. Hallelujah. Sometimes we got to forget where we at.
Yes.
Hallelujah. Forget about our trials. Leave
yes.
them on the side.
Yes.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. The devil is going to come in after all of us.
Yes.
I'm going to tell you one thing, too. Amen. The devil knows who you are,
yes,
Mother Sister.
Yes, he does.
Hallelujah. He knows who you are.
Mm-hmm.
That man may not know who you are. Hallelujah.
Yes.
But the devil inside that man
yes.
knows
yes.
who he is.
Yes.
Hallelujah. So we rest in knowledge and strength and love.
Yes.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Sometimes we got to look on the spiritual side.
Yes, yes, always.
Amen.
Yes.
See beyond
always.
The physical.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Yes, God.
Sometimes we say, well, it's that person, it's that person, that person. But we got to realize
yes,
that it's a double.
Yes, Lord.
Amen. It's not really him.
Yes.
Amen. So we ask God that God will continue to bless us.
Yes, Lord.
Continue to have a good time and a
yes,
high time.
God.
In the Lord.
Yes.
Praise the Lord.
Yes, yes.
Amen. For this is the house of God.
Yes, Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Yes.
And in it we shall what? Rejoice.
Yes.
Amen. Amen. And
yes.
be glad in it.
Amen.
Yes. Praise the Lord. Everybody just turn around three times. Hallelujah. Come on now.
Amen.
Glory to God. Hallelujah. That's one time. Hallelujah. Come on. Hallelujah, that's
yes.
two times. One more, hallelujah, that's three times.
Yes.
Praise the Lord, amen. Sometimes
yes.
we don't feel like moving.
Yes.
Sometimes our body don't want us make,
yes.
don't want to let us move.
Yes.
Amen.
Amen.
And praise the Lord, we ain't here to enjoy the Lord. Praise the Lord.
Yes.
God, we ask you, Lord, to look on brothers and on feet and turning right now,
yes,
God. In the name of Jesus, God, we ask you, Lord, that you touch them, God.
Yes.
Lord, move in the situation. God.
Yes, God.
In the name of Jesus.
Yes,
God.
Father.
We thank you for the strength that you've given them, God.
Yes, God.
God,
yes, God.
We thank you for the patience that you've given them,
yes,
God.
Yes, Father.
We thank you for your grace today, God.
Yes, God.
Lord, continue to move on his daughter, God.
Yes, Lord.
In the name of Jesus,
yes,
God.
Lord.
Move on his wife, God.
Yes, God.
In the name of Jesus, God.
Jesus.
Lord, we ask you, God, that you have your way, God.
Yes, have
yes.
your way, God.
Not our way, God, but your way today, God.
Yes, yes, Father.
Not our will, God, but your will today, God.
Yes.
In the name of Jesus,
yes,
God. Let him rise up, God.
Yes.
In the name of Jesus.
Yes.
God, we thank you.
Mm-hmm.
Praise the Lord. Amen.
Yes. Amen.
Give it honor to God. Amen.
Yes. Amen.
The mother of the church.
Amen.
Praise the Lord. Amen.
Amen.
Mother Silks, praise the Lord. Pastor Heavenly, praise the Lord.
Yes,
amen.
Lord.
To all your sisters and brothers,
mm-hmm.
Pastor, praise the Lord.
Amen.
God is good.
Yes,
Yes,
yes.
Amen.
And we're going to continue to lift up the name of Jesus.
Yes, Father. Thank you, God.
Amen. Because that's where our blessings go.
Yes.
Yes.
I mean, after going through all week and everything, fighting the devil and everything,
amen.
You know what I mean? We need to come in the house of God and shout a little
yes.
bit.
Yes.
And there ain't nothing wrong with it.
Yes. Amen. Yes.
Ain't nothing wrong with it.
Yes.
Yes. Ain't nothing wrong with it. Down.
That's right.
Amen. We got it on.
Yes.
Praise the Lord. Amen. Amen. And that's what the devil get mad at. The devil get mad when you have in church.
Yes. That's right. That's right.
Amen. When you have in church, he get angry.
That's right.
He get real mad.
Yes.
Somebody say, if you want to make the devil mad, have church.
That's right. Amen.
Just have church.
Yes.
Amen. Praise the Lord. Amen. Right.
Yeah.
Thank God for the sister that was up here praying. God ram in the bush.
Yes.
Yes.
Praise the Lord. I thank God. Amen. So, amen. So, you know, this is not our service, my service.
Yes.
This is not the pastor's service.
Amen.
Praise the Lord. This is not your service.
Right.
Amen. It's not your service. Not your service. Not your service. Mm-hmm. But it's our service.
Yes.
Praise the Lord.
Yes.
And we're going to get out of what we make.
That's right. That's
praise
right.
the Lord.
Amen.
Don't think, man. Give God the
yes,
glory.
Lord.
You feel
yes,
like
Lord.
This. I mean, when you got the Holy Ghost,
yes.
hey, man, we stop doing a lot of things when,
yes.
we, feel, when we first
right.
receive the Holy Ghost.
Yes, yes.
Amen.
Yes.
When we stop,
yes.
we need to start back.
Yes.
Amen. Yes. Hey, that's why I like about David. That's why I be my dude
yes.
on. But David went through the street neck.
Yes, he did.
Dance.
Yes, he did.
Rejoice.
Yes.
Praising God. Hey, we got clothes on. Praise the Lord. We don't want to give God a shot.
Yes.
Amen.
Praise the Lord. Get out of ourselves and
yes.
concentrate on
that's
Him.
Right. That's right.
Amen.
Yes.
Magnify the Lord. Concentrate
yes.
on Him.
Yes.
And forget about your troubles.
Yes, Lord.
Amen. Praise the Lord.
That's right. That's
amen.
Right.
So we're going to do our happy song. And I'm going to hand it back.
Right.
Amen.
Amen.
Y'all ready for this?
Yes.
Praise the Lord. Everybody standing.
Yes.
Amen. If you're happy and you know it, clap your hands. If you're happy and you know it, clap your hands. If you're happy and you know and you really want to show. If you're happy and you know it, clap your hands. If you're happy and you know it, stomp your feet. If you're happy and you know it, stomp your feet. If you're happy and you know it, and you really want to show. If you're happy and you know it, stomp your feet. If you're happy and you know it, say amen.
Amen.
If you're happy and you know it, say amen.
Amen.
If you're happy and you know it, and you really want to show. If you're happy and you know it, say amen.
Amen.
If you're happy and you know it, do all three.
Amen.
If you're happy and you know it, do all three. Amen. Come on, we need a little loud on the amen. If you're happy and you know and you really want to show. If you're happy and you know it, say amen.
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 I messed up this time. Praise the Lord. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Amen. We thank God for pastor.
Yes.
Amen. Pastor, you want to come up?
Yes.
Please come up, Pastor.
Hmm?
Praise the Lord. Amen.
She prayed.
Hallelujah. Hey, man. I'm going to ask Sister Francine, can you get in the way? Come raise a prayer. Let that baby go. I'm your Moses. Let my people free.
Yes.
Let's go. Come on, raise a prayer, Sister Francine.
Praise the Lord.
She'll be fine.
Amen.
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 So, Sister Francine got the hair on there.
Oh, yes. Nice.
You know, good on camera.
Nice.
Good morning, everybody. I'm always bad. How's everybody this morning? I was reading something on the way over here. I was on the Action News, and I'm they have their website, and I was reading. It was an accident last night, and I didn't get to read the whole thing, but four women were in their limo, and they were going to a bachelorette party. They were excited, you know, they were celebrating, got hit by a drunk driver, killed all four of them.
Jesus.
Just like that. 1 minute they're partying, happy, probably in their 30s, same age as me. Next minute, all four of them are gone. That just proves to you how short life really is. How you never know within one moment they're riding along, and the next moment they're all gone. So that just says be thankful. I say it all the time, be thankful. Be appreciative. Be aware to the fact that God has kept us.
Yes, Lord.
You hear about the storms and the tornadoes, and you just hear about everything going on in the world. And, you know, they said a tornado will rip away one house and bypass the other one.
Yes, Lord.
So you come out your house and the house next to you is flat and yours is still standing.
Yes.
Don't worry about the material stuff that's in there. God kept you. God protected you. He kept your house standing for a reason, you know, and we just need to be thankful because this area has not gotten hit like other areas. For some reason, it keeps circling around us, it keeps going below us, it keeps going above us, it keeps slowing down before it gets to us. So we all just need to thank God. This week has just been a struggle. It's been long. Like my mom said yesterday, we had a yard sale, and we had the devil right across the street from us. Thought he was going to stop something, had our signs taken down, and I believe he went down and took them down himself. And just because you weren't happy, because we were just trying to do something on our, we're not bothering you, we're not hurting anybody, we're doing something positive, all we're doing is cleaning out our house, and for some reason, somebody saw a problem with it. But you know, God is good. Because, you know, we had a good day yesterday. It didn't rain. I was getting phone calls from my sister. I had a phone call from my boyfriend, from my aunts, from friends. It's raining over here in PA. It's downpours. It's downpours in New York. My sister called, it's downpours in Virginia. I'm like, it's 90 degrees here.
Yeah.
I was like, we ain't seen a raindrop all day long. So, you know, I thank God. And like I said, it's just been a struggle. And I thank God I made it through the week. It's tiresome. Is everyday life, and I just thank God for him, and I just want to say a little prayer for everybody.
Yes.
Father God, Lord Jesus, we come to you in the need of prayer.
Yes.
Not just the people sitting in this room, but the people beyond these four walls.
Yes.
Lord, I ask that you touch all their hearts, their souls, their minds, their bodies. Lord, we need people to get back to you.
Yes.
We need people to know you.
Yes.
Lord, for the people that just feel alone, like there's nobody out there with them, let them know that you are with them, God. There's so much going on in the world, the killings, the storms, the natural devastation. We just ask that you just protect us, Lord. Put your hands of protection around not just us, not just churches, but everybody on the street, people on the corners, people in their homes, people in their car, buses, trains, everybody, people coming to the United States, people outside the United States. Lord, touch the families of those four women that got killed. Lord, touch the families of those Marines that got shot in Chattanooga. Lord, unnecessary violence is going on in this world, Lord, to your people. And we just ask, Lord, that you just be with each and every one of us. I just pray that everybody just gets a blessing financially, gets a blessing just for their strength, just gets a blessing to keep themselves whole, just gets the strength to just make it through, not the next day, but the next moment. Lord, we just thank you for all things, not material things, but all things. Being able to walk, Lord, being able to talk, being able to see, Lord, being able to touch, being able to have food on our tables, being able to have clothes on our back, shoes on our feet, water to drink. We just had an outbreak of contaminated water, Lord. We ask that you just fix it, Jesus. Just be in the midst of everything, Lord. The big things, small things, things that people don't think are important, but to you they are important. We ask that they just seek you, Lord. You say, come as you are.
Yes.
You don't care about the hair being done. You don't care about the clothes you got on.
Yes.
You don't care about the jewelry you wear. You don't care about the shoes on your feet, Lord. You want them to come to you as they are. All you want is them and nothing else. And Lord, I just say thank you. I just give you the praise, the honor that you deserve. Lord, I just ask that you just keep everybody in this house. I ask that you just protect this congregation, that you just know what their desires are, Lord. Know what their heart needs, Lord. Know what their families need. Know what they just want and what will just make them whole, Lord. That you just be that empty spot in their heart. That you just be that empty spot in their home. That you just be that emotional security, that financial security. That you just be there for them, Lord. But Lord, all you want is just them to come to you. You want them to, as my mom says, come on in that room. You want them to come to you and lay at your feet, Lord. You want them to let you handle their situation. The devil is busy, Lord, and we're here today to beat him down. We're here today to say he's a liar, Lord. He can't have anybody in this room or outside of this room, Lord. This time you take back everything that is ours, everything that is yours. It's time that we just give you the praise, the honor, and the glory that you deserve, Lord. And I just ask that you be with each and every one here today. From the pastor, Pastor Scott, from Reverend Jesse, from the pastors in the audience, Mama Scott, my mother, the young lady and her husband that are here. I ask you to be my little girl running up and down the aisles and tearing up everything, Lord, but just keep her, Jesus. I ask that you be with Brother Brandon. Every time I see Brother Brandon, I just hug my daughter a little tighter because I know that could be my little girl.
Yes, Lord.
Yes, Lord.
Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Father. Thank you, God.
I thank God for all that he has given me.
Yes, God. Bless the Lord.
Thank you, Jesus.
Bless you, Jesus.
I don't know where I would be without God on my side. I don't know where I would be if God wasn't touching my family. I don't know where I would be if God wasn't just with me. Sometimes I feel alone, Lord, and I know there's other people in the world that feel that same way. And Lord, you fill that void for me each and every time. And I don't have the words to describe how thankful I am. I don't have the words to describe how much you have just carried me from one situation to another. I don't have enough time in my day to say thank you. I don't have enough time in my day to tell you how appreciative I am. You are worthy for every praise that is went on here today. You are worthy of just everything we do throughout our day. We don't have enough time to tell you how worthy you are. We're not worthy of the things you bless us with, what you do anyhow. And Lord, I just say thank you.
Yes, Lord.
I just say thank you for everything, Lord. Everything that you have done and will do. Just keep us, Lord. Just keep touching us from the top of our head to the soles of our feet, Lord. Just, and speaking of feet, touch my foot, because for the past month, it's just been a problem. But Lord, I keep going on anyhow, and I do that through you. And I just say thank you. Lord, I say thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. In Jesus' name.
Yes.
Amen. Thank you.
Yes. Thank you, Jesus.
Yes, Lord. The working power in the blood of the Lamb. There is power, wonder-working power in the precious blood of the Lamb.
Free from your burden of sin, yes, 'cause God will.
Amen. She didn't know she was going to do that.
Amen.
Hallelujah. But she did good. Wonder working power in the blood of the Lamb. There is power, power, wonder working power in the precious blood of the Lamb. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Hallelujah for the power in the blood. Amen, amen, amen. I'm going to ask Francine to sing more, I think. Hallelujah. She came up here not knowing what she would do. Everybody in this church can do something. Everybody in this church will do something. Amen?
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. One more song. We're going to move on with the service. Amen. Just please bear with me. Hallelujah. God is good.
Amen.
God is good. My mother come lead the song.
Huh? Yes.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Don't be laughing at nobody like you laugh at Francine. Let's go. Come on, mother. Mother sings in the house. Hallelujah, Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, Jesus. It's so good to be here today.
Yes.
I'm going to give him all the glory, the praise, and the honor because he is worthy to be praised.
Yes, Lord.
Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Glory, glory, glory. Thank you, Lord. Thank you for everything this morning.
Yes, sir.
Somebody said, what's so good about waking up this morning? God woke us up.
Yes.
And that is good because he woke us up this morning. He says, it is a good morning.
Yes, it is. Yes,
it is a good morning.
Yes.
Without him, we can't do nothing.
Yes,
amen.
You know, so we need him in our lives every minute, every hour, every day.
Yes, Lord.
And we give him all the glory because he's worthy. Oh, yes. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
This is the day. This is the day that the Lord has made. That the Lord has made. I will rejoice, I will rejoice and be glad in it, and be glad in it. This is the day that the Lord has made. I will rejoice and be glad in it. This is the day that the Lord has made. This is the day that the Lord has made. That the Lord
and be glad in it.
This is the day that
Yes.
Yes,
be glad at it. Rejoice in it.
Yes,
no other way.
Yes, Lord.
This is the way.
Yes,
yes,
God.
Be glad and rejoice in it.
Yes, Father.
Oh, praise His name. Thank you, Jesus.
Yes, God. Hallelujah. Bless Him. Bless Him.
In Jesus' name.
Bless Him, Lord.
Praise the Lord. Thank you, Jesus.
Yes, thank you, Lord Jesus.
Amen. Amen.
Amen. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah.
Thank you.
Yes, thank you, Lord.
Hallelujah. God is good. The word is to be praised.
Yes.
This is a morning of praise. We came forward to fight. We got things we want to win. We're tired of losing. We're going to win. God is good and worthy to be praised. We just thank Him. We praise Him. We magnify Him and we adore Him. Thank you, Jesus. Oh, hallelujah. That's right. Praise Him. Praise Him. Praise Him. Praise Him right. Praise Him for only being. Let all who have come praise the Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you for your praise. Thank you for your son. Thank you for the fight. Thank you for the struggle. We just praise you. We magnify you. We adore you. We lift you up. We give you the praise and the honor and the glory. I thank you, Jesus. I thank the word of God said when Paul and Silas was in jail, what they did to get out, they praised Him. That's right. If you're in prison today, a prison of your finances, a prison of your emotions, praise God today and watch those chains fall off for you. Amen. Thank you, Lord. We worship you. We magnify your name. We lift you up. Thank you, Jesus. Yes, Jesus. God is good. And He is worthy to be praised. We honor Him. We adore Him. We give Him the fruits of our lips, Jesus. Thank you, God. Oh, that's right. That's right. Words are a powerful thing. That's right. Because in the beginning, God said what? Let there be light. And there was light. You can speak too over your life. Let there be light over your life. Let there be light over your circumstances. Let there never be darkness over your circumstances. Weeping may endure for a night, but what? Joy cometh in the morning. Joy comes this morning. It's proof of that verse. Joy is here right now. We're going to worship Him. We're going to praise Him. We're not going backwards. We're going ever forward. We're going to get this thing done right, no matter what it takes. God is good. He is worthy to be praised. The word of God said that He went upon the cross and died for us. And we just want to say thank you. Thank you, Jesus. We worship you. We magnify and we adore you. God is good all the time.
Yes, He is.
Amen. 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 Grab a Bible if you can. Grab a Bible if you can. If you can't, grab somebody up, grab somebody's Bible.
Thank you, Jesus.
Amen. Yes. Get a Bible.
Thank you, God.
You don't own a Bible? Take one of those. Anyone you want.
Yes, Father. Yes. Thank you, God.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Amen.
Yes.
Amen. I remember I was opening this church and I was saying, where am I get Bibles from? All of a sudden, every thrift store I went into had Bibles, a dollar, five for a dollar. So that's why we got to ask the Lord sometime. You know, please. That's the problem. I think more than once somebody said up here that we have not because what?
Yes,
we actually ask Him.
Amen.
Ask Him for the big things.
Yes,
ask Him for the little things.
Amen.
And watch Him get it done. Amen?
Yes.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Grab your Bible. Hold up high. Hold that Bible up high. This is your sword.
Yes.
Say, it's my sword. That's right.
Yes.
And I am who God says I am.
Amen.
Amen. Don't you be afraid. When the devil whip out his sword, whip out yours. Back. That's right. When I say spades, what we call that? A wild card? What do you call it? I don't know, but you know what I mean. Man. Turn your Bible to Leviticus. Leviticus 6:13. Leviticus 6:13. We're not going to be long today. Reverend Jesse says, thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. Amen.
Amen.
Leviticus. Genesis, Exodus, Leviticus. Okay? Chapter 6, verse 13. And it says, the fire shall ever be burning upon the altar.
Mm.
It shall never go out.
Mm.
Lord, we thank you for your word. We love you. We magnify you. We adore you. We lift you up. We give you the praise and the honor and the glory, O Father God. Lord, give the blessing that makes preaching easy, O Father God. Let's heart be pricked and consciences be set afire right now for you, God. Lord, when we have failed, shore it up right now, O Father God. Enable us within ourselves that our fire never go out. Lord, we thank you. We love you. We adore you. And in your holy name we pray. Amen.
Amen.
Leviticus is one of those books, Leviticus and Deuteronomy, one of those books that it's hard to read because it's all about ordinances, things we have to do. And in Leviticus it talks about how we should sacrifice, what the priest should wear. So it's hard to figure out what are they talking about in Leviticus. But it's a very powerful thing in both these books because, you see, the Bible is not always literal. Sometimes we have to take it spiritual. Mm-hmm. In fact, the Bible is a spiritual book.
Yes.
So when he's talking about sacrifices and what you should wear, he's talking about when you worship, you got to be particular.
Yes.
You have to ask for the thing you want. You just don't come to God anyhow. Mm-hmm. So sometimes if you're an embarrassment to yourself and all you're saying is, thank you, Jesus, it's good.
Mm-hmm.
But the woman who had the issue for 14 years, she didn't say, thank you, Jesus. She pushed through that crowd, didn't care how it looked, how she looked, and she didn't look good. Okay, but she pushed through and she just said, if I could just touch the hem of his garment, I will be healed. And what did she get? She got it done. So be particular. And this book, Leviticus and Deuteronomy, is about being particular. It's about how your worship should be. Because it's about preparation to come to the altar.
Yes.
In this particular verse, we're talking about the fire shall ever be burning upon the altar. It shall never go out.
Mm-hmm.
Now, by fire, what does that mean? You know, when those days, they would take animals and they would burn it. They would put them on the altar and burn them. The first altar that's built by man that the Bible recites is with Noah.
Mm-hmm.
Noah had just found land and he was happy and he built an altar. He said, that's why he's saying by that I shall make a time and a place that I shall worship the Lord.
Yes.
You see, altars doesn't have to be this. Altar doesn't have to be that. The altar is where you make time and place to praise the Lord. That means that you have to make time and place.
Yes.
If you get into trouble and you don't have a time and a place, you never establish it, it's hard to get out.
Yes.
Because you're going to be in distress. You're going to wonder what to do.
Yes.
But when you have an altar, when you say there's a time and there's a place, maybe in the morning, maybe all throughout your day, it could be whenever something hits your heart that ain't right, that you start to pray within your heart.
Uh-huh.
That's the time and the place, and that is okay.
Yes.
You just got to remember that when you in need, you find a time and a place to pray. You don't need no big, strung out, long pray. You need to pray in your own way.
Yes.
Each apostle was different. Someone has something else to do, and none were alike because they found themselves as they were in Jesus, and that's what we need to do. But on this altar must be the fire, and the fire is the hardest part because the fire is not just I'm going to light a match. You know, sometimes you got kids who light matches. I used to light matches, but we're not talking about that. We're not talking about being a pyromaniac. We're not talking about being a fireman. We're not talking about being a chef or a barbecue person. We're not talking about lighting a candle and burning all night. We're talking about whether or not you have devotion for the Lord. And so this is important because, let me tell you now, because there's a woman who Jesus watched in the synagogue, and she came forth with what? What did she have? One mite. And everyone came up there with all these things, bullocks and cows and rams and sheep and all these things to sacrifice. All she had was one mite, but Jesus said that even this woman only had one little mite. That is all she had to probably to her name. She brought it forth. It means bringing forth with all that you have. Your sacrifice is not mine, and mine is not yours, and yours is not less than mine. Mine is not more than yours. You bring it across with what you have. You see, because of the word of God said, if we have faith as what? As a mustard seed. And a mustard seed is small, that we shall get it done. And it's about devotion. So you make that place in your life. You make that time and place we're going to worship in the Lord. And you don't worship him haphazard. You worship him with everything that you got. And everything that you got might not be screaming and howling. Everything that you got might be your broken heart.
That's right.
Everything that you got might be the thing that shames you day in, day out.
You wake up in the morning and it's like good morning heartache looking you in your face, the same thing that's been dogging your heels for 30, 20, how many every year? It's right there. And that's when you give your might. Because to me, that thing you got might be a might, but to you, it's a heavy burden. And don't let people think because it's your problem, it's no big problem. People tell you, oh, that's nothing. Later for them. It's nothing because it ain't theirs. It's your problem. You come across, you bring that thing. You know, sometimes we don't want to pray to God we don't want to pray about ourselves.
That's right.
We're going to pray about who pushed me off the bridge when I was only looking. Mm-hmm. We're going to talk about who left. Mm-hmm. We're going to talk about who did what.
Yes.
Who fired me.
Uh-huh.
Who pushed me. Who shoved me. Who robbed me. Who slapped me. Mm-hmm. Who took what they shouldn't have took that wasn't theirs in the first place. And we get all hurt and bothered by the situation all the time. But what we need to do is say, God, I let it hurt me, God. I was with the wrong person, Lord. Lord, I was where I shouldn't have been in the first place, Jesus. Lord, what do you want me to learn from this circumstance? Let me tell you, the enemy came in like a flood for Job. And he did. And Job didn't sit to tell him about it. He didn't talk about the devil got me, Jesus help me. He stood there in the ashes, scraping his sores, and he said, I know my Redeemer lives. That's what you have to do. Because all the enemy wants to do is get you off track. Get you so that you're not looking at God anymore. So what you look at, your sorrow.
That's right.
You look at the things you've done.
Yes.
Look at the things that you didn't do.
Uh-huh.
You look at the things that they did to you.
Yes.
And once you look at that, you make pain an idol. Mm-hmm. Pain is your thing.
Yes.
Let me tell you, the Bible also says that Lazarus was there. But they didn't look to that. They looked to Jesus.
Yes.
And they said, Lord, my brother Lazarus is dead. And if you had been here, it wouldn't have been so.
Yes.
And then what did Jesus say? He said, Lazarus, come forth. And that's what he said. You got to look to Jesus. It don't matter what happened. I don't care what you did. You could have set fire to 10.